हेलो गाइस, सो टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द SSB मॉडरेशन एंड डीमॉडरेशन इन मैटलैब कोडिंग फॉर्म आल्सो एंड इन मैटलैब सिमुलिंक आल्सो। दिस इज योर फिफ्थ एंड सिक्स्थ एक्सपेरिमेंट। तो इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस यू हैव सीन दैट वी हैव डन दिस कोडिंग लाइक इन AM मॉडरेशन, DSPHC, ऑल दिस कोडिंग यूजिंग डायरेक्टली द फॉर्मूला। मीन्स द फॉर्मूला ऑफ AM सिग्नल इज 1 + KAMT इंटू CT। सो वी हैव यूज दैट फॉर्मूला इन आवर कोडिंग। ओके, एंड वी हैव जनरेटेड द AM सिग्नल। सेम गोज विद द DSPHC। बट हियर वी आर नॉट यूजिंग दैट फॉर्मूला। वी आर डायरेक्टली यूजिंग मैटलैब फंक्शन। इंस्टीड ऑफ दैट फॉर्मूला वी आर डायरेक्टली यूजिंग अ मैटलैब फंक्शन विच इज कॉल्ड एज SSB मोड। एज यू कैन सी हियर इन आवर प्रोग्रामिंग इट इज कॉल्ड एज SSB मोड। ओके, दिस इज अ इनबिल्ट फंक्शन ऑफ मैटलैब। ओ इट विल डायरेक्टली गिव यू द फॉर्मूला एंड इट विल जनरेट द SSB मोडलेटेड वेव। इट इज वेरी यूजफुल। सो these things are already present in the library of MATLAB, so we are going to use these things because it made your work quite simple and you have understand in previous classes what are the basics of coding and how you build these formulas. Okay, how you generate the wave using those basic formulas what you learn in theory classes. And in this classes I am giving you a step further, advanced step, or to use directly the functions which are inbuilt in MATLAB library instead of putting those in formulas. So this is useful. It will save your time and it will give a good result. Okay, that's why we use this thing. So this library of communication library is already there in your MATLAB. Okay, in 2021, so you can use this one. This SSP mod formula. So in this program, when you will see, it starts with FM is 10 hertz, FC is 500 hertz, or keep it 150 hertz. No issue. We have used one sampling frequency here because when we use SSP modulation, then we need sampling frequency. The sampling frequency, you know that sampling frequency is double of the message frequency. Okay, but here we have used more than double. We have doubled the message frequency, then added with the carrier frequency, and then we have doubled and 10 times. So that for precaution, it gives good result. So this is on you. You can change these values and you can see what are the differences you are getting in your message signal. And this AM and AC is just same as the amplitude. Okay, message and carrier signal. Now comes the time span. Here we are taking our time span according to our sampling frequency. It starts with 0 and it will go till 1 by fs. Means what are my sampling frequency is till that time it will perform. And we need 2 cycles. We need 2 cycles. That's why we have taken 2 by fm minus 1 by fs. So it will give a time range, okay, of 2 cycles because it starts with 0 and it will go till 1 by fs. So we are subtracting 1 by fs by 2 by fm because sampling frequency will go to the twice of fm. So just for 2 cycles we are taking. That's why we have taken this formula. And this is the angular frequency of message signal. This is the carrier frequency of angular frequency of carrier signal modulation index. And this is our message signal. And this CT is our carrier signal. As you can see in S1 is our SSB AM modulated signal. Okay. In this formula, SSB mod, inside this bracket you have to take MT. MT is our message signal. Then you have to define the FC. FC we have already defined it here, 150 hertz. So directly you can write FC. And then FS, We have already defined it here, fs, sampling frequency. Then comes the last part, which is of plotting. As you have already known this thing, same subplot and plot we have used. Same thing for first for message signal, then for carrier signal. Third is for modulated signal, and this plus AC plus MT and minus AC minus MT, just see the difference, upper limit and lower limit. Now we can do the demodulation in two ways. Using Butterworth filter also we can do, but we have already used these things in our last class. That's why I am not using this in this class. So here we are using directly inbuilt function of SSP demod. SSP demod directly, and it will ask for message signal, which is S1, then FC, which is carrier frequency, and the sampling frequency. So we have directly used this inbuilt function SSP demod, and we are plotting the demodulated signal. Okay, quite a simple program, nothing much in it. So what we will do, we will run this program. Okay. Yeah, you can see getting the output, quite good output. Okay. This is our modulating signal. I have told you it will only go till 2 cycles. So it comes from here and 2 cycles. It only completes 2 cycles. Okay. That's why we have taken that kind of time span. Okay. Now this is the frequency, carrier frequency. This is the SSP signal. Okay. Modulated one. See how low is this. Okay. Very low. So this is our SSP modulated signal. We can see the difference here, upper limit and lower limit. Okay. Now we got the demodulated signal at the output. Okay. So this is your SSP modulation. You know you will get only single sideband, okay, not the double sideband. Here also you are getting only single sideband. In single sideband here in modulation. So then you have to, now this was your experiment number 5. Now what you have to do, we will do this same experiment in Simulink, MATLAB Simulink. Okay. So I will cut this one. You will save these things and you have to attach this in lab report. And yeah, there is one homework for you people. I will, for your understanding, just do one thing. Like I have used this SSP mode, direct inbuilt function of MATLAB. Instead of this, you use the formula and try to do this same experiment and get the output using this formula. Okay, you can do that. Okay, now we will switch to save this one. Okay, save this one. Then now we will switch to Simulink. Will go to Simulink. Yeah, Simulink is already there. So we can start Simulink, or I have already started Simulink and I have built a circuit in Simulink. So one by one I will tell you what are our circuit is. So first one is signal generator. I have already taught you people how to build this circuit. Okay, the connections and all, everything, how do you have to search and you have to drag these things from a library browser, just search and drag the source signal generator, whatever you need. So this I have already told you. So I will show you the parameters here. In signal generator, I have used sine wave. Okay, amplitude is 1 and frequency is 10 hertz. Okay, it is in hertz. Yeah, this is rate transistor. This is just to control the data. Okay, as you can see, data transfer between rates and tasks. It is Okay, we don't have to change any parameters in this. Directly, this is a rate transistor. You can search and you can drag and drop connected here. So next is, like in coding, we have used directly the formula. So in Simulink also, we can directly use the library of SSB AM signal, okay, which will modulate the SSB signal. We don't need to do summation and product and all. You can do that. That is, you can practice that, okay, using summation and product of message signal. Then you will take one carrier signal generator. Then you will plus and minus all these things, and then you can observe those output. Or instead of that, we can directly use a library of SSB signal, which is available in MATLAB. And from that, this block will automatically do, it will do everything for you, okay? Every formula, every product and summation and subtraction, whatever it is needed, this block will perform inside that. And you just use this library, okay? So this is the SSB AM modulator passband, as you can see. And the carrier frequency I am putting here is 150 Hertz, okay? And everything are default. You can choose sideband to modulate, means you can go for upper band or lower band, whatever you need. Because as you know, in SSB, we only take any single band, okay, whether it will be upper band or it will be lower band. So it will be any single band. So I am here opted for upper band. You can opt for lower band. That's your wish. Okay, so this is my SSB AM modulator. Next, what we put, this is the SSB demodulator, AM demodulator. Okay, here also the carrier frequency is 150 Hertz. And you can see the low pass filter design method here. It is also Butterworth. Like we have used analog filter in last class in DSPSC or in AM modulation also. For demodulation, we have used Butterworth, okay, as a low pass filter. And the filter order is 4. So in this demodulator also, this Butterworth filter is already there. So it will do the work. We don't have to attach another analog filter. Got it? So this is the use. Cutoff frequency is same, 150 Hertz. So you give this parameter, click OK. Okay. Next thing is power spectral density. Okay. I have used this power spectral density for the length of 512 buffer. Points will be FFT points is 512. You will learn what is FFT in your signal and system or in DSP. And this plot is for 500 point. Sampling time I have taken, it will be very low. That's why I kept it 0.001. Okay. Spectral density means you can observe the power spectral, okay, in form of time, magnitude, phase, all these things you can see at one place, okay, and in the form of power spectral density. That's why we have used this specific library, this specific block. So we have used this three blocks of power spectral density. See, this is power spectral density 2, this is power spectral density 1, and this is power spectral. Power spectral density 2 is of, it will show the message signal, okay? Power spectral density 1, it will show the modulated SSB signal. Power spectral density will show the demodulated SSB signal. And here I have used one scope also. Scope will also show you the same thing. So not a very big difference. But just for reference, I have used one scope. Yeah. So this is the SSB Simulink circuit. Okay. You have, this is your experiment number 6. You have to perform this thing. And you have to attach it in your lab report. So now I will run the program. And we will see the output. You can see we got the all three power spectral density output here. Okay, so this is our starting message signal, this is our modulated signal, and this is our demodulated signal. And here you will see magnitude also and phase also, magnitude and phase. That's why we have used power spectral density. Okay, you can see this is the demodulated modulated signal, okay, with magnitude and with phase. Phase will be in degree, and this is our modulated one. Okay, this is the output of power spectral density. Now if you will see the output of a scope, so as you can see, this is our message signal above one. Middle one is our SSP modulated signal, and lower one is our demodulated signal, SSP demodulated signal. So this is there not much difference between scope and power spectral density. Power spectral density will provide you some extra information. Okay, so this is done. Okay, this was our experiment number 5 and 6. Okay, perform this experiment, save this Simulink. Okay, try to save every program and Simulink each and every time. Okay, so run this in your MATLAB and attach all these codings and Simulink diagram wagera, everything, including these parameters screenshot in your lab report. Okay, okay then, so okay, fine. So that's all for today. Thank you.